Welcome to our St. John's Parish family on this second Sunday in Ordinary Time. At this Mass, we remember in a special way Geraldine Moscatello. Please stand and give a sign of welcome to those around you. We begin our liturgy singing number 486, The King of Glory. Number 486.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, welcome to this celebration of the second Sunday in Ordinary Time. We are here only a few days after we concluded the season of Christmas. And as we gather, we ask ourselves how much from that joy, that peace, that love, that kindness and generosity is still left within us. And we gather today with a challenge to truly bring that joy and peace and knowledge that God is with us all the time into this ordinary season and to each and every day of our lives. As we gather, we send our love and blessings to all those who are watching us online, or those who are in any way connected with us, either through prayer or their sacrifice or simply through their love of our parish. We send our blessings and best wishes also to Deacon Al, who is recovering from his surgery, and to his family as he's progressing well and as we hope to have him back with us very, very soon. But also our love and blessings go to all those who struggle or suffer in any way. So as we begin this Mass, let us once again declare our dependence on our loving and eternal God. Let us ask for his pardon and mercy, for his blessing and guidance for every day of our lives. Lord Jesus, you are the Lamb of God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you sacrifice yourself for your beloved people. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will draw us together into eternal life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us into everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God,
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, who govern all things both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our time. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord said to me, "You are my servant, Israel, through whom I show my glory. Now the Lord has spoken, who formed me as his servant from the womb, that Jacob may be brought back to him, and Israel gathered to him. And I am made glorious in the sight of the Lord, and my God is now my strength. It is too little, the Lord says, for you to be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Jacob and restore the survivors of Israel. I will make you a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth." The word of the Lord.
The responsorial psalm response tonight is, "Here I am, O Lord, here I am, O Lord, come to do your will."
Reading from the beginning of the letter to St. Paul to the Corinthians. Paul, called to be an apostle of Jesus Christ by the will of God, and Sothenes, our brother, to the church of God that is in Corinth, to you who have been sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be holy, with all those everywhere who call upon the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, their Lord and ours. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. John the Baptist saw Jesus coming toward him and said, "Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. He is the one of whom I said, a man is coming after me who ranks ahead of me because he existed before me. I did not know him, but the reason why I came baptizing with water was that he might be made known to Israel." John testified further, saying, "I saw the Spirit come down like a dove from heaven and remain upon him. I did not know him, but the one who sent me to baptize with water told me, 'On whoever you see the Spirit come down and remain, he's the one who will baptize with the Holy Spirit.' Now I have seen and testified that he is the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, as we gather last Sunday and then on Monday to celebrate the baptism of the Lord, with those two beautiful feast days of the Epiphany and then the remembrance of the Lord's baptism, which once again brought up the name of St. John the Baptist, obviously, we are here for the second Sunday in ordinary time. We had a very interesting dilemma as we tried to keep this church nice, clean, and beautiful all the time. What to do with all these Christmas decorations? And the dilemma was very real, not only because suddenly we are back in a season of ordinary time, but because many of these poinsettias that we had in front of us were and continue to be as fresh and beautiful as they were on the first day when we brought them in. So we decided that the Christmas trees will go and many of these lights will go, but at least some of these poinsettias need to stay. Not only to keep this church beautiful, but also for each and every one of us to stay at least for a little while as a reminder. The challenge that we asked, or the questions we asked in the beginning of this Mass, how much of that Christmas joy and kindness and generosity and that conviction that Jesus is with us because he came to live among us and die for our salvation, how much of all of this still remains? And I'm sure that as you look at these poinsettias throughout the Mass, they will serve to all of us not only as a reminder of the joy-filled season, but also perhaps as a little bookmark on the story of our lives, reminding us that that season, that Christmas, that joy needs to be lived now in the ordinary circumstances of our everyday lives. And in order to help us, Church is giving us a beautiful passage from the scriptures to read. We just read a passage from the Gospel according to John, from the very first chapter. We are in the beginning of the season of ordinary time and the beginning of the new year of 2023, so it's not surprising that this passage comes from the very first chapter of Gospel according to John. It is that Gospel that in the beginning especially sounds very, very different than other three Gospels. John is using his very poetic language to describe the triumph of Almighty God, the triumph that happens in a total self-giving and humility, descending from heaven above to live among us and to die for our salvation. So that Gospel begins with the words, "In the beginning was the Word, and that Word was with God, and that Word was God." But only after a couple of lines in that first chapter of Gospel according to John, we may find the name of another John, the one that once again appears in the passage that we read a moment ago. Our John, St. John the Baptist, our great patron, the man we are so proud to declare as a patron of this community of faith now for about 95 years. And in this passage that we have just heard, John makes a very public declaration of the divinity of Christ. In fact, next time you enter to the main door, look up and you might see something that you have not noticed in years and years passing by through those doors. Above that entrance are those exact words that we read in the Gospel of today, in the very beginning from the 29th verse. "Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world." Yes, dear brothers and sisters, they are the same words that we say together as priest recites it shortly before we receive Holy Communion, before we come and before we are nourished over and over again with the great gift of the Eucharist. "Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world." And once again, we look at the great wisdom and faith and love of those of our ancestors spiritually who built this church and put it so nicely together. And that reminder, like those poinsettias here today with that scripture quote, is above the main door, just that we can be reminded each and every time when we gather as a community of faith that yes, Christ is the Lamb of God. He's the one who takes away the sins of the world. We come and gather every time when we celebrate Mass to declare this divinity. We come to listen to his word. We come to receive the Eucharist. But we also come as humble human beings who declare and recognize that since the last time we were here, we have failed, perhaps on various occasions. But he's our Lord and Savior, and we ask him for his pardon and mercy. He's the one who washes our sins and who brings true liberation into our lives. As you read that first chapter from Gospel according to John, you might notice a very interesting detail. John doesn't mention the name of Mary and Joseph and others who were so much part of that story of the descent of Almighty God from heaven above and coming among us. But he wanted to highlight his spiritual presence, the drama that happened with the descent from heaven above, but also the fact that he stays with us today and every day, the same way as in the moment when he descended from heaven. And then when you read that John's Gospel all the way to the third chapter, you may discover perhaps one of the most known quotes, at least from those moments when we watch television or see some of our brothers and sisters making a public declaration of their faith. You have seen those signs, John 3:16, that connect us to the words of the Gospel of today, to the declaration that Lord is our Savior and our God. In the third chapter, in the verse of 16 of John, we read this: For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. The entire first chapter with all its drama perhaps is summed up in that one verse. The entire story of the scriptures and the life of our Lord Jesus Christ is so densely described in that one verse of John. And it once again reassures us that Jesus is with us in the dramas of our lives. We have once again had a challenging week in our parish. We have lost some of our parishioners, some quite young. We have lived through the stories of our own lives, and perhaps every one of us can now get up and tell how the week went. And today we stand here in front of another great unknown, and that is tomorrow, or next week, or next month, or this entire year. And on that journey, we receive that loving reassurance of Christ through the words of our great patron, St. John the Baptist, that Lord is truly our Lord, that he is our Savior, that he is our Redeemer, that he is with us and guides us each and every day of our lives. So let us, as we celebrate this Mass, as we have listened to the Word of God, as we once again look at these little reminders of the Christmas season, and as we ask ourselves, so how this new year will be like, or what this new week will bring, let us go back to that source of life, to that source of light, and to that eternal reassurance that the one who gave his life for us will be with us today, tomorrow, every day of our lives, and fully in the eternity. So let us look at the example of St. John the Baptist. Let us once again be inspired by this great saint. And let us, as a community of faith, together grow and declare together how much we love Christ, how much we need him, how much we are willing to sacrifice for him, and how much, once again this week, we want to go and proclaim that faith to our brothers and sisters. Amen. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake was crucified under Pontius Pilate, and suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again the glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. John the Baptist testified that Jesus is indeed the Son of God. Let us offer our prayers as testimony to the divine presence among us.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, may God continue to raise up faithful men and women who will respond to his call with, speak, for your servant is listening. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of all nations, that they will seek the wisdom of God and work to promote peace among all nations, especially in Ukraine. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those for whom this time of year is a burden, may the Lord draw near to them in their sorrow. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, that we remember that we are the body of Christ, called to bring his message to our world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are preparing for baptism, especially Arcady, fill their hearts with a love for the Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are ill, and for those who care for them, that they may be strengthened by God's healing touch, especially John Smith, Jane Ripley, Rita Brotgam, John O'Hare, Frank Capsoris, Rose Stigliano, William Raymond, Anne Marie Miles, and Deacon Alganter, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died and gone before us in faith, that they have followed Christ's way in this life, they may now share in God's eternal vision, especially Elaine Greenan, Raisin McLaughlin, Mark Ryan, Dorothy Afanasieff, Margaret Rosenbauer, John Flanagan, Dolores Farrell, Dino Favetta, Patricia Davis, Greg Hillerman, Eileen Lai, Jackie Montanaro, Madeline Montanaro, and Madeline Catherine Smith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Geraldine Muscatello, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, look with favor on the requests we have put before you. Beyond all of these, we ask you to give us ears to hear your call and hearts ready to respond to what we hear. We ask this to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As our gifts are gathered and prepared, please join in singing number 686, Here I Am, Lord. Number 686.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry,
pray, dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name,
our good and all his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state. And by his suffering, Christ canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and a chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Geraldine Moscatello, and all the members of the Geraldine's family have gone before us. Grant that they who united with your son in that likeness may be also one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with blessed apostles, Saint John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we are married to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now let us pray in the words our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word of my soul.
The hymn for communion tonight is number 726. Make me a channel of your peace, number 726.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. Oh, Master, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
Please join in singing number 874, Precious Lord, Take My Hand. Number 874.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand.
Let us pray. Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart. We ask this to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
That behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, perhaps sounded a bit different today. And every time when we hear it at Mass, let us remember that it came from the mouth of our great patron, St. John the Baptist. And symbolically, it came from the mouth of each and every one of us as we gathered here today. So thank you for being here, so many. Thank you to those who are joining us online and who prayed with us during this Mass. And once again, we want to assure you of our prayers and our love. There are a couple of announcements in the bulletin, so please take bulletins with you, and those who are watching us, you can find it always on our website, and in like two simple clicks, you get to our bulletins, which you can also enlarge and read it anytime you would like. So please, that is one of the sources of information that we can access every time about what is going on in our parish. But before the final blessing, I just would like to pause for a moment, perhaps, and reflect with you just very briefly on that long list of brothers and sisters that passed away. I'm sure that as we were reading the prayers of the faithful, many of you thought, like me, when is this going to end? Because that list was so long. But we pray with that same knowledge and same conviction that we pray during this entire Christmas time and in the beginning of this new season of ordinary time, that every one of these brothers and sisters, members of our parish, our loved ones who died recently, is now eternally sharing the Christmas and the loving embrace of Almighty God in heaven. And just one person that certainly represents that group of our dear parishioners who are mourning during this time, I would like to say give special greetings to Tammy Hillerman, who is here with us at this Mass, and who lost her dear husband Greg only a couple of days ago at the young age of 59. Greg was a firefighter for many years in Ridgewood and served that community and many other communities with great love, and passed away after a short battle with very serious cancer. So all those of you who are in these names and your loved ones that we read today, please know that this community loves you and cares, and we will continue to support you and mourn with you, but also look to the moments when we can rejoice constantly with that knowledge that Lord is our Savior and our guide, and He leads us each and every day. So for that, let us now receive this final blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Be gracious to your people, O Lord, and do not withhold consolation on earth from those you call to strive for heaven. And may Almighty God bless you, your loved ones, and keep you always in His love and care, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and our brothers and sisters. Thanks be to God.
We are sent forth singing number 533, All Creatures of Our God and King. Number 533.
All creatures of our God and King, lift up your voice and with us sing. Alleluia, alleluia. O burning sun with golden beam, and silver moon with softer gleam.